الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين يا رب. حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا من الراشدين. آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، فأنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، خلق فسوى وقدر فهدى. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، الرحمة المهداة والنعمة المسداة والصراط المستقيم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدرهم ومقدارهم العظيم. وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وارض عنا معهم يا رب العالمين، آمين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is my honor to meet with you through this virtual channel, trying to get some thoughts about what is happening in the world nowadays. It is very amazing to see a small virus, very, very tiny one, cannot be even seen by the normal microscope, give the whole world a big headache, challenge our science, our technology, and our advancement in every field of knowledge. Cities around the world are closed. Many businesses are shut up. Even airlines are down. Conferences, all kind of summits are cancelled. And that is because of a small virus. Subhanallah. If there is something to learn, we should learn a lesson how weak the humans are. The lesson we learn is, if we have to compete in this life with one another, if we have to race with each other, it's not to race who is the strongest or who is the richest, or who is the most advanced in technology, although all that is legitimate. But what we should really focus on is how much we are true to our values, how much we are true to our faith, how much we are true to Allah, God the Almighty. This is the kind of race that we should really get ourselves in. Because it doesn't matter how strong you are, this kind of virus proves how weak we are. It doesn't matter how advanced we are, almost 4 or 5 months, and the whole world is struggling to find a solution for this virus, a medicine for this disease that stop us or take away our freedom, even the freedom to walk outside, the freedom to meet with our families. And that is not limited to one nation or one faith or one ethnicity. That is all over the world. And that reminds us with the last sermon of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Valley of Arafat, when he talked to the humanity in general, أيها الناس كلكم لآدم وآدم من تراب. O mankind, all of you, regardless of your color, regardless of your ethnicity, regardless of your religion, regardless of where you come from, you are the children of Adam, and Adam came from dust. That is our origin. That is where we started. That is why If there is a relationship to bring all of us together, is our human relationship and our faith. If it does not contribute to the human relationship, is not worthy to be a faith. That is why, brothers and sisters, this kind of a challenge put us in front of this question: how true are we to our values? How far we are committed to what we believe in? That is the question that we should be asking ourselves every minute in our life, especially nowadays. That is why, brothers and sisters, in this kind of situation, we come to seek comfort. We come to seek connection. And we come to value the religion, value our relationship with our Maker. That is the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in Surah Al-Hujurat, which is Surah number 49, verse 13. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan nas. Allah does not say, O Muslims, or O Arabs, or O American, or O white people, or black people. Allah says, O mankind. Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. I have created you. We have created you from a male and a female, and made you into nations and tribes that you may recognize each other. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. That you may become familiar, that you may become helpful, that you may become respectful to one another, that you may rush to help one another in the situation like this. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala added in that verse, Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. The most honorable of you in the eyes of God is the one who is so mindful to God, who is more mindful, who is more fearing. He is more doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to. And sadly enough, if you know, in this situation, Muslims, especially in the what's so-called Muslim or Arab countries, they still live in the theory of blaming others or conspiracy, al-mu'amara, that America made it, China made it, they want to break up this country, they want to destroy the economy of this and that. It is very saddening that people are looking all over the world to find a solution for the problem, a treatment for the disease, and the Muslims are pointing a finger to other people, sitting around doing nothing. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in so many verses in the Quran that righteousness is not just to sit around or to talk about the way you direct your face to the east or the west. But righteousness is to help other people, is to feed the hungry, is to treat the sick, is to give the needy, is to give comfort to those who are in a stress. That is what righteousness is. That is the competition, that is the race that we should get ourselves in. That is why the most honorable one in the eyes of Allah is the one who have more taqwa. And the word taqwa is being misinterpreted and misunderstood by many Muslims. So they define taqwa as to grow your beard or to be a reader of the Quran or to pray up, to stay up all night reading. All of that is good. But they are missing the point, which is at the time of hardship, there is another kind of taqwa. There is another kind of understanding of the value of faith. Is not to sit and doing nothing, but is to help other people. That is why in this kind of situation, the lesson we learn that we should soften our heart, that we should be merciful to one another, that we should remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. Be merciful to those who are with you on earth, your brothers and sisters, all creatures, so you can be qualified to be to have to be showered by God's mercy. So that is the lesson we learn, brothers and sisters, from this virus that is called COVID-19 or coronavirus. So that is the value that our religion teaches us. Very small thing put us in front of ourselves. How true are we to our values, to our religion, to what we believe in, how human we are. So that is why we read in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ ضُرِبَ مَثَلٌ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهُ وَإِنْ يَسْلُبْهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُوهُ مِنْهُ ضَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطْلُوبُ. It's so amazing to know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for more than 1400 years ago that verse that talk about الذباب, the little fly that we keep buzzing us, keep hurting us and knowing us all the time. It is mentioned once that a king was sitting once and the fly came to land on him. So he kept buzzing here, off here and there. And then he asked one of the wise people sitting around him, why God created this kind of fly? لماذا خلق الله الذباب? What is the purpose behind this annoying fly? Then the wise man said to him, Allah created that fly to teach a king and the dictators and the arrogant one like you a lesson in humility. ليعلم الله بها المتكبرين أمثالك درسا في التواضع. That Allah may teach through this fly a lesson to those who think that they are bigger than everything, that they have control over everything. Subhanallah. Now the whole world under the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody is begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help. Even the biggest nation, the United States of America, they are puzzling. Almost 2,000 people gave their life for this kind of disease. Today, it is almost 200,000 people are affected by this virus. And that is to teach us that there is a God, there is a supreme being, there is someone that we are living under his control. It doesn't matter how rich, how big, how great, how advanced we are, there is someone who is akbar, who is higher than us all, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah creates things you have no idea about. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows what are the soldiers or the troops of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah, but himself. That is why, brothers and sisters, our faith should be directed to be more productive, not pointing finger, not taking the theory of conspiracy, not blaming others for this or that. How much are we giving? How much are we developing? What is our commitment as Muslim nations, as Muslims, as believers, as humankind in this situation? That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran is telling us, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Instead of pointing a finger, lend your hand of kindness to help other people. There are people who are working, sacrificing their time, even their lives, to help those affected by this virus. Those doctors, those nurses, those who work in the medical field, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with them. They are in front lines. They are making whatever they could to save lives. I think those people must be appreciated, must be kept in our prayer. We should ask Allah to protect them and to keep them safe and sound, because these people are very vulnerable to this kind of situation and this kind of virus. That is why the purpose of the human life is to serve and to show kindness and the will to help others. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Help one another in birr and taqwa. And birr means righteousness, which means to do all kind of good deeds. So iman or faith is not limited to say, I believe in Allah, I believe in God, and do the prayer. That is the easiest part of iman. That is why the Prophet ﷺ, whenever he was asked about who are the best, من أفضل الناس يا رسول الله, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, أنفعهم للناس. The one who is so useful to other people, the one who is so helpful to other people, the one who reach out to others, to feed the hungry, to calm the one who is in trouble, to help those who need help, to rush to those who are in hardship, and there is no really manifestation for our faith nowadays better than to work with our community to see those people who lost their job, who lost their income, they cannot find money for rent, they cannot find the food. Those elders who are home alone, they cannot come out to buy their food. We should really lend them a hand. We should check on our community, our neighbors and everybody, and try to manifest our humanness in this kind of way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about in the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ. Have you seen him, the one who deny the deen, the day of judgment, or the religion? فَذَلِكَ الَّذِي يَدُعُ الْيَتِيمِ. That is the one who pushes away the orphan. وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. And he does not urge, is not only enough to feed the hungry, but you are commanded by God to urge others to feed the hungry. وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاءُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ. One of the attributes or the description of those who deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who are showing off, and because of that, they do not worry about helping other people. وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ. They have the money, but they do not give. They have the time, but they do not contribute. They have the ways and the means, but they do not really make any difference in people's life. This is the kind of manifestation for our faith, brothers and sisters. That is why, do not ever sit and say, you know, someone is fault. It is someone's fault. No, you have to find a remedy. Instead of cursing the darkness, light a candle. Instead of saying it is so and so, how come and all of that, you should really ask yourself, what did I do for that? This is the kind of commitment that we should be putting ourselves in, because after all, we all are living in the same global village. What affects others affects us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surely gonna ask us about that. So this is the time of the hardship that we the Muslims should be fulfilling our obligation to our neighbors, our families, here or abroad. We should be doing something to help other people. The least we can do is to ask God Almighty and pray for those who are affected and to protect our nation and the whole world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reach out to the heart and the soul of those heroes who are working around the clock in the hospitals to help other people, to reach out to them, and they put themselves in danger. I am so concerned about them. May Allah be with them. May Allah bless their heart. And may Allah preserve them and protect them from all kind of harm. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.